In today's episode, we're going to be going down to Datum to watch them build the 1/3 scale fuselage models. Now, you may be wondering a couple of things, like, who am I? My name's Josh, and I'm a videographer and photographer with a passion for aviation. And one of the other things you may be wondering is why build a 1/3 scale model? And the answer is, I don't know. So I'm going to ask Jason.
Fundamentally, the way we're making the fuselage for HX50 is quite novel. We're fusing technologies from other areas of industry, wind turbines, boat building, commodity composites, with aerospace quality and the tolerance controls that we need for a highly stressed aerostructure. And so we need to be very certain that we're going to get what we expect out of the monolage, and that the process that we're using will suit the structural design that we've opted for. Now, obviously, we could just go to full scale, but that's much more expensive. The way that you would make tools at full scale is different to how you can do it if you make a part scale model. By doing that at third scale, we can do it at greatly reduced time and cost. So we can quickly prove that we can lay the fibers where we want them, hold the fibers where we want them, bag them quickly and effectively, seal the sides of the tools together properly, and infuse the whole thing without dry spots or any problems. So while we're doing that in parallel, the full scale design is being finalized and optimized. And as soon as we know we can make it using this process, we'll release the tooling for the full scale structure. So it's a de-risking exercise, and it's a program acceleration exercise that just allows us to do things quicker and better. So one of the themes that runs throughout the whole Hill and HX50 program is the fact that we're not looking at general aviation and future general aviation aircraft through the constraints of how we've always done it. So working with people like Datum allow us to absorb that and to apply that to our product development process and deliver a better aircraft faster than ever before. The way the pattern making process works with a modern workflow is we deliver our tooling design. So our engineers have designed the structure, then they design the tools and the tooling architecture that they want to be able to manufacture those composite parts. What they do is they buy this stuff in stock sizes. They can block it all together to create an envelope that's big enough to contain the part that you're trying to make. And then they pop that on their CNC machine and machine away all the stuff that you don't need, leaving just the shape of the tool that you want. So just the impression of the surface panel that tool is designed to lay up and manufacture. And to do that, there's a number of important steps that they have to go through. They have to successfully block the material together. They have to hold the material. They have to stress relieve the material so that any stresses that have arisen during its manufacture don't then unwind as you start to remove parts of the material and leave you with a distorted tool. And so they'll then go and cut the shapes that we want. And then finally, they'll use a 3D scanning process to go and make sure that the geometry that they've created is what it was supposed to be from the 3D CAD file, that we've actually got the shapes that we need to be able to manufacture the composite parts.
So there we have it, the reasons for building the 1/3 scale model and how we're doing it. Now in the future, I will be documenting the process as it comes along with other developments and updates. So, be sure to look out for things like what's behind me.